Welcome to Short Game Saturdays. We're in illustrious company today. We've got major winner, gold medal winner, Justin Rose.
Hey mate.
How you doing?
Yeah, good.
And Ryder Cup start. Sorry,
thanks,
forgot
mate.
That. There we go. All right, okay. One of the best wedge players in the game.
Okay.
What do we do? We're hitting like a 30-yard wedge shot. What do you work on?
Obviously, I've just got to the range, so you've caught me kind of, you know.
Warming up.
Warming up. So, but I think obviously a warm-up is always a great opportunity to work on your wedge play.
Yep.
So right now, actually, all I'm really working on is a little bit of the sequence of how I want my backswing to go. But I think the most important thing, I'll kind of try to work with the camera here. You know, with a long game, I always think it's really important, all good ball strikers, they have the center of mass, which is the sweet spot, behind the hand path, right? It's always tracking in from behind the hand path. A lot of amateurs will get the sweet spot kind of, out in front of the hand path too early, then they get jammed up at impact. Great players have it behind, or always behind, and then obviously eventually it'll square up and get in front. But for me, with a short shot, especially 30 yards, I always want to feel like the center of mass is tracking the hand path. So when I look down from a bird's eye view, I always try to feel like my left arm and the club create a straight line. So if I want to hit a spinny shot, I'll hinge it. But when I look down, so that looks outside the line from where you are, but when I look down my arm, my left arm and this club are in a straight line. So if I have to hinge it this way, my left arm and the club are now in a V. That way it's in a straight line. Now if I release, it's in a straight line, release. So I can now release that club in this fashion here. Every time I look down, that club's in a straight line. So that really, basically that's keeping the center of gravity, the sweet spot, tracking the hand part. For me, that's a great way to check 30 yards and under.
All right, let's have a look.
You don't want to create any, there's no need to create speed. So for me, first, the wrong one. Use the bounce there. Obviously the contact was to the hair behind the ball, but if you have good technique, contact is not as critical.
Oh, exactly. You've got more margin for error.
Yeah, but as I kind of gear up through my chipping, I then kind of work on a clock face too. So as I go into my wedge play, I regulate my distance by using my left arm. Left arm to 9 o'clock.
Yep.
9 o'clock with a 60 gives me like a 45-yard shot.
Yep.
10 o'clock with a 60 gives me a 75-yard shot. And then a full 60. It's still, the arm swing will only get to 9 o'clock, but I have more 10 o'clock, but more body turn.
Yeah, more rotation.
More rotation.
You're going to have
tension.
A fuller follow through.
And that's a 95-yard shot. So that's kind of how I dial in my wedge play, and obviously I'll have that same kind of system with my 50 and my 56, and obviously my wedge as well. So anytime I fall between 140 and 50 yards, I've got a go-to, and I've got something that I can work on.
Perfect.
Let me just demonstrate maybe a little 10 o'clock. A little 10 o'clock 60, just to give you guys an idea what that might look like. I try to feel like it's balanced on both sides of the ball. 10 o'clock backswing, 10 o'clock arm swing.
Beautiful. There we go, guys.
That's it.
Work on your pitching. Listen to what Justin does.